Hello, everybody. Andrea Majewski here with Dentalelle. So what do you do when you're waiting for a check? Okay, so these are things that I do that just seems to help to lessen the obvious of you're waiting for the dentist to come in to do a check. So number one is I will always book their next appointment, depending on if you're the one who can do that, if you know how to do that. But if you do have that capability, it's such a good idea because that will take time. You know, say to them, oh, you know what, since we're waiting, or you don't even have to say that, but say, oh, you know what, let's keep it up with every 4.5 months because things have improved a lot, but the gums are still bleeding. So how about we book your next appointment? Do you prefer Tuesdays or Thursdays? You know, something like that, but book their next appointment. So that way the front desk is happy, the patient's happy, it's just taking a little bit less time. Another thing to do is if you haven't done this yet, give them their toothbrush, toothpaste, and then make a little small talk like, oh yeah, do you use a manual toothbrush or do you use an electric toothbrush? Or what color would you prefer? You know, pink, purple, blue, because I don't want you to have the same color toothbrush as somebody else, because that's the worst thing when somebody else uses your toothbrush, right? You know, make small talk, I don't know, whatever. Another thing is ask them if they want some water. Nobody does this, but maybe they're thirsty, or offer to get them some magazines. If I'm working at a dental office and I know that I'll have to wait a little bit for a check, then I will go up to the front, grab a couple magazines because you never know which ones they're going to like, and just say, she or he is just going to be in another 5 more minutes. Sorry to keep you waiting, but here's some magazines for you. Or ask them again, oh, did you have any questions about anything? Because she'll just be another 5 more minutes, but it shouldn't be too much longer at all. Things looked pretty nice today, so we're actually done early, and the dentist just probably wasn't expecting that. You know, say things like that. If your patient isn't interested in making small talk, that's okay. Take your notes. This is what I do to stay on time. When I'm waiting for a check, I take my notes and write in the chart so I don't have to do it later. I have the worst memory ever. Yes, I can do my charts at the end of the day, but I'll probably forget something. Write down what you said to the patient, write down what you had recommended, all of that. Take your notes. It does help. If you're doing all of that and still waiting, another thing that I like to do is say, I'm just going to grab a couple things to help the dentist because she might need me for something. Or I'll just say, I'm just going to see if she needs any help. You might not be helping them. You might be doing your own thing, but that's telling the patient that you understand that they're still waiting and you want to make sure, see if you can speed things up a bit. So when I do that, I leave the room and I set up for the next patient because I can't really help the dentist. We're probably waiting because she or he is finishing up with the patient. So what can I do to speed that along? I can't, right? But I will do other things to set up for the next patient. I'll put the instruments through, you know, because maybe your patient doesn't want to make small talk and there's nothing worse than sitting in the room like this while you're waiting for the dentist. The nice thing is, I have my own practice. So when I go to patients' houses, I don't have to wait for the dentist because there is no dentist. So that's kind of cool. So that's never an issue. But if you're working in a dental office, obviously that's a big issue, right? But that does help so much to just let the patient know that you are aware of their time. Another thing, if you're waiting a long time, which can happen in some offices, you might always have to wait for a check. If you have that patient that you can tell is getting annoyed, you can say to them, I apologize, it's going to be a little bit longer. Are you able to stay? Because I probably shouldn't say this out loud, but if enough patients leave because they're waiting for a check, hopefully the dentist will catch on like, okay, you can't keep the patients waiting for half an hour. I don't know about you, but I've been working in offices before where the dentist is just taking their time doing other things that they really don't have to be doing, but they're literally just taking their time coming to you for a check. They might be checking other people who have not been waiting as long as you. They might just be taking notes in a chart that can wait. They're just being them, if I can say that. So I have no problem telling patients, I'm sorry to keep you waiting. Are you okay to stay another 5 minutes? If you have to go to work, I completely understand. I will just take off the fee, obviously, for the exam today because you didn't have one. So I do say that. That might be a bad thing to say, though, you guys. So I'm not saying do that unless, you know, you're comfortable doing that. But that's what I do. Because, again, if the dentist sees that enough patients have left because they're waiting for a check, then maybe they'll think a little bit harder, right? And if you're waiting half an hour for a check, you're now behind, you guys, half an hour. So that probably means you won't have a lunch. You'll be working a lot later. You'll be home later. I can go on, right? So that's what I do. I hope that these tips helped. Let me know, though, if you have any questions. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.